The surrounding was filled with festivals. Everyone in the neighborhood was planning for something. There was an excitement in everyone. Some planned to travel, some were preparing for a long trip. Some were planning to go for cruise holidays, and some got holidays to finish their personal jobs. But the most important thing was when Prashant shared his idea of spending a night at a graveyard on Halloween's day with Amal. It was really a childlike idea. Everyone was shocked. Well, they must have been because of Amal's tremendous fear about the ghost. He is so afraid that sometimes, he sleeps with his parents still now. So they just laughed at the idea. Everyone was gathered around Vivek's house. As it was a holiday in their college, they were spending their time enjoying with friends. Nihar said to Prashant, "That's impossible. He can't do that." Tuhin said, "And also you can't convince him, because we know about the last year's activity. Forgot that? Ha ha ha." Vivek laughed at Tuhin's remark and added, "Yeah Tuhin, I can't forget the day." As the movie was running in the middle, and the ghost unexpectedly came on the screen, Amal's attitude was attractively noticeable. Ha 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 ha. Amal had gone already silent after hearing the plan. He is frightened by the ghost but doesn't show it. In fact, he used to say he didn't believe in ghosts. So, he was not expressing his views on this. There was a negative approach in his voice, but controlled. Everybody was familiar with his behavior. So they were waiting for his surrender. But he was not a boy who would surrender easily. He just said, shrinking his face like it's not a matter for him, "Okay, I'll try." They knew that he would avoid it by showing some reasons. Nobody believed firsthand that Amal would go with Prashant, but at last, he convinced him as Amal's girlfriend was one of his college friends. So he had to go. But there was something else waiting for him. The day finally came. The weather was magnifying, the sky was blue, breezy wind, and there was a message of winter's coming. But Amal's palpitation was increasing. He thought he would hide himself somewhere, but it was difficult. The more hours passed, the more palpitation he was feeling. He couldn't refuse his friend's demand, thinking about his girlfriend wouldn't accept his proposal. He had been running after her for a long time, but the lady was not giving any attention to him. He thought it might be a good opportunity to impress her. Finally, he also made a plan as he was familiar with his friend's activities. Prashant said his friends, Nick and Pick, the twin brothers who would disguise as ghosts and make him afraid. It was just an enjoying matter for them. Some of his friends knew this plan except Amal, as he was the scapegoat. At night, Amal and Prashant entered the graveyard, which was near their house. Their parents were unaware of this. Otherwise, they might obstruct. It was the darkest night. Clouds were not visible in the sky. There was only one light in the graveyard, but it was not covering the whole area. The pin of silence was prevailing inside. They could only hear the sound of crickets, their breath and shoes. Sometimes, to break the profound silence, they were talking to each other. Prashant asked, "How are enjoying the beauty, Amal?" Amal replied, "Beauty. What kind of experiment is this?" Prashant said, "Silence, silence, did you hear the sound?" Amal knew that Prashant was doing this to make him afraid. Amal replied with false expression, "What sound?" "No, no, there is no sound. I can't hear anything." Prashant said, "Please listen carefully. Don't you hear the sound of someone's walking?" Amal replied sarcastically, "Oh yeah, yeah, it's mine." Prashant frowned. They became silent again. The surrounding seemed the calmest place. And this is why it could be a great place for meditation. At 2 a.m., Amal asked, "Do you have a cigarette?" "I am drowsing." Prashant gave him one and took out another for him. They were both smoking. As the weather was a little cold, they were shivering, though they had been covered with sheets. Prashant asked, "Can you do this?" He put the fire portion inside his mouth and closed it. Then again took it out. The cigarette was still burning. Amal countered him with another question, "When are we going home?" Prashant replied, "At 6. Amal checked his mobile. It was 2:30. Amal whispered, 3 30 hours more. Prashant said, okay, you wait here. Let me find a place to pee. Now, Amal shockingly shouted. Shhhhhhhhhh, what are you doing? Prashant asked. I'm coming. Please wait here for a few minutes. He went. Amal was checking his site as if he could plan something else. So he followed him until he was not outside. Now Amal was alone inside the graveyard. He was waiting for Prashant. It was 3 on his phone. He was sneaking everywhere, but there was no trace of him. So he started to walk toward the gate. As he was walking, he heard someone was following him behind, but there was no one as he turned his head. When he was just in front of the gate, 2 black covers worn were striding toward him. Amal was out of his mind. He couldn't decide where to go, what to do. Suddenly, he lost his conscientiousness and fell on the field. 2 persons looked at each other and went near him. There was a little bit of silence. They disclosed their black cover. Nick nudged Amal, but there was no response from his side. Prashant came then. He shook him, Amal, Amal. What happened? They looked at each other with fear. Pick whispered, did we do something wrong? Again, Prashant shook him hard, but there was no reply. They took Amal on a rock beside the gate. There was no water at their reach. They could go to their home, but everybody would know it. They were waiting. Nick got angry and charged Prashant, who told you to make this kind plan? We are all aware of his fear of ghosts. Then why? Pick started then, have you gone out of your mind? If anything wrong happens, what we will answer to his parents? Sorry, I'm extremely sorry, Prashant regretted. I didn't realize it would turn like this. He nudged him again, Amal, Amal. They became silent. The graveyard was silent until some birds broke it. The sky was smiling with the rising sun. Amal suddenly woke up and said, "Happy Halloween, guys."